Hello and welcome back to me. Yes, it's been a very long time, 7 months, 8 months. Life took over, I won't go into it, but alright guys, for those of you who are new, this is a tutorial-based research program, and apologies for the mic. I'm using a crappy old mic, so hopefully I'll be able to sort something out soon. So another moon module landing thing, basically I'm just going to be trying to highlight the fact that we are all being taken for a ride, and the images that they promise us we won't get, and the images they do show us, like on the Artemis mission, stating their 4K stunning images, I've spoken about it before, are absolutely not, but people seem to believe the titles and don't understand. I don't understand. So anyway, the other day, oh my god guys, right, the stuff I have got to show you coming up is no two ways about it. That's it. Buildings, structures. I just went on a bit of a hunt. Rather than going through my old files, I just thought I would try it. Anyway, right, I'll get on with it. Okay, so this is the image which you've probably seen if you do follow any of this sort of stuff. And this is in the Malapert? Crater area. It's Malapert A. This is the image they gave out. And there we have Odysseus. This is supposed to be it. So when I had a look at this image, you know what I'm like. So this didn't look right to me. And of course, this is the landing site, and I've already heard them talking about, yes, the cameras are working, and yes, we're going to be getting stunning photographs, and I guarantee you, we will not get any stunning photographs. So let's just have a quick look up here. Around. I'm presuming this is a crater edge. And, you know, straight off the back, there's not really a lot to see, and nothing actually standing out, unless you look into it a little bit more. There's some strange stuff in here, but you know, you can put that down to this high quality image, which apparently was taken by the LRO. It just happened to be in the right place at the right time, apparently. So here it is here, this tiny little thing. Let's see. No, that's my enhanced version. So where is the, all right, here we go. So this one down on the southern end, I'm not sure what crater that is, but I'm presuming this is the crater of sorts, and this is the area that it's landed in. Okay, so after finding this, I thought, okay, let's see if we can find any better images. So I went to the quickmap LRO site, and as you can see here, I put in that, and this little area here, I hope you can hear me, I'm not wasting my time here, right, and this is the marker it gave me, or the area to look in. There's my cursor from the screenshot. But straight off the bat, and I'll show you this in a different video. I've got some of the Japanese as well. That's a cool one. So this is the area. So I'm presuming Malipur A area is around here somewhere. But straight off the bat, can you see this stuff? Yeah. Like I say, and this is from the quickmap site. So let's okay, so this is the enhancement. Now if you're new to this and you're still with me, these mottled areas are the areas which, if you can see my screen going dark there, I've still got problems with my screen, so bear with me. These are the areas which I've enhanced. So we go straight in. Now this is supposed to be the Odysseus here. And right next to it is this familiar looking structure. I can see stuff all the way. I wasn't going to do anything, but might have to here, just to, for those of you who are unfamiliar. So here we go, here we have the module. It's quite funny as well. Just let me show you this quick. This is the NASA YouTube channel, and there's an hour 22 minutes of complete twaddle, basically. Let's just play this. Don't know if I can hear anything, or you can hear anything. I'm all plugged in or whatever, but he's a NASA bod. But don't waste your time watching this. I think CNN did a 20 minute version, so you can have a look at that. And quickly while we're here, this is Malipur crater. This is where I got the thing from. So all the information is out there. And the reason I show you this is so you can find out what they're saying and basically what they're not telling us. So back to here is the module, and here is one of our very familiar looking platform structures with the bits on the top. What are we? Okay. If you're new, I'm not drawing anything. I'm literally using a dodge tool which makes the pixels darker or lighter. You can choose which shade of pixels you use and stuff. So, and I do recommend pausing and just getting used to these images, because we are pulling them out of filters or masking programs which are designed to hide these features, because we're not supposed to see them, basically. And this is the information which is in the images. There's no point arguing with me or anything like this. I will just simply go try it for yourself. I know it's not as easy for everyone to use these programs and stuff, but with the tutorials on the site, on the channel, and I'll help you as best as I can. And it's the only way to find out for sure. So let's have another look around here. Like I say, give yourself time, there's an angle on it, you can see the shadows, you can see the stops, and you can see the direction and the purpose of the structure here. You'll probably think, what is he looking at? Is he on drugs? But no, it's something you get used to. Remember, you're not supposed to be able to see this stuff. So you can see I'm not drawing, I'm just scribbling over the areas I want to pull out, and I'm trying to get them to a level where you can see what is going on. And they mix this stuff up with blurring and whatever filters they use or programs they use. And I've tried to highlight a few bits here and there, because once you start pulling everything out, which I have a tendency to do, it gets very confusing. Even for me, you know, it takes a while to tune back into what we're seeing. Okay, so these are all around the crater edge and stuff, but you can see this is hopefully going to be a short video on my part, because I've got so much of this stuff to show, and it's the Aristarchus crater, and I've got loads of stuff on it, and it is just phenomenal. No two ways about it. I'm going to be sending it everywhere. You simply can't deny it. But anyway, back to this one. So you can see the formation of these stuff here. There's a lot more work that he's doing on this. Let's see. Got something else I'll show you, because my computer blew up a while back. And this is all new. So being a bit of an old git, I get very used to using things, and when I have to change, it's a whole new, you have to relearn everything again. But yeah, I can't believe it's been so long since I've done anything like this. So basically, I've just been searching for new stuff. And for those of you using phones, if you're still with us, I've just got something else I'll show you, and we can get in a hell of a lot closer. So can you see this here? Very structural. So let's have a look here. You see that? There. Just going to go back. Look at that. That's how they mask it up. See that? It's all in here. There's one of those platforms with a tower on top. So this stuff is everywhere, like we've spoken about so many times before. Just pause it and check this out. What I would recommend, I think my screen is 23 inches, so if you want to see exactly what I'm seeing in the clarity of the size of the screen that I use, then use a 23 inch or bigger. That'll work. Okay, right, let's have a look at this. So this is the enhanced version. Let's just do that. Oop. Zooming in on the module. So this is the module. So what it's saying to me is that this has landed slap bang next to or in and around these structural features. So that's why we are not going to see any funky photographs, which they rave about all the time. And I don't understand how people do not notice this. So hopefully this would look quite cool on the phone. Take a huge amount of time to enhance this. Just check this out. See these here, it goes back in on itself and under. So obviously the lighter parts are the highest points. And maybe that will give you an idea of perspective and how you're looking at it with the shadows and stuff. This bit hasn't finished yet, it needs more work on it. But it's nice to see part of the process. It's like this. This would be like that. And you make it lighter, darker, lighter, darker, using mid-tone and the light tones. Don't tend to use the shadow too much. It's quite brutal. Okay. Cheers. Go and have a quick look at that. Oh, no, it doesn't work the same way. I hope you can hear me. I don't think I'll be doing this again. I might do, where is it? When you're doing this, you'll notice that things are cut up with shadow, so you don't see the how these things are joined together until you do this type of enhancement. But it is very time consuming. The more you work on it, the more details you can pull out. Okay. And here are the structures. Right. Okay, guys, right, so what I'll probably do, I will show you some of these next. Got an eye for this, you'll be able to see this stuff straight off. See? Check it out. Yeah, this isn't at its full resolution yet. See? Right. Thanks guys, I hope you enjoyed this one, and I will be back as soon as I can with the follow-up from this, or I'll do the do a Japanese one. It's another landing site, very interesting. Okie dokie, see you soon, cheers.